slightly transformed. Just a bit of a break from the norm. Just a little something to break the monotony of all that hardcore dance that has gotten to be a little bit out of control. It's cool to dance, but what about a groove that soothes and moves romance? Give me a soft, subtle mix, and if it ain't broke, then don't try to fix it. And think of the summers of the past. Adjust the bass and let the alpine blast.
Summertime. News and Talk 1380 WAOK, the voice of the community. I am Slaughter. This is The Movement. Intelligent Black Talk Radio, blowing you up from 7 to 10 each and every day. You know what I'm saying? Exposing you to the real and checking all that fake stuff. You know what I'm saying? Yes. Checking at the door. In the studio with me, my dear brother Javon Brown, author. Oh. Author and Toastmaster.
Yes.
And tell folks about Toastmasters, because everybody don't know what Toastmasters is. Tell folks about Toastmasters.
Toastmasters is a leadership group that I joined probably about a year ago at my job at the Department of Revenue. That's where I work. Mm-hmm. Right. At the Department of Revenue. And you learn leadership qualities, but the main thing you learn is how to talk in front of large crowds. Mm-hmm. So if you have fear of talking, period, or shyness, you're going to get thrown out the window. So I joined it because I knew I was writing a book, and I knew that I probably have to talk in front of large crowds and mm-hmm. talk, period, about it. And I kind of talk pretty fast sometimes, and I stutter sometimes. I don't really stutter that much anymore since I joined mm-hmm. Toastmasters. It's actually been a great tool. So I stand up in front of crowds.
Yeah, I detected that. I mean, the first work that I did was in audiology and speech pathology, so I caught the little... The slight stutter, yeah. But you do very, very well, yeah. And you seem to have mastered.
Yeah, and just got to slow down and use the techniques that I've learned in Toastmasters and just mix all my thoughts together and stay calm. It works pretty well. I actually just won last week for Toastmasters. I won best overall speaker and my group. I guess best overall speaker and best tabletop speaker. So it's mm-hmm. worked out pretty well, and I've talked in front of large crowds every week, so it's doing very well. I'm glad I joined. My mom was actually part of Toastmasters when I was younger mm-hmm. in church in Maryland. So I kind of knew about it before that. So mm-hmm. I went ahead and joined, and it's pretty cool. So
other than Toastmasters and the book, what else you got going?
I work at the Department of Revenue, business analyst, but mainly right now the book is my main focus. I put it out this past March, so mm-hmm. it's still a baby. It's not even a year old, and it's been doing very well.
You're getting in traction.
Yeah, I'm getting a lot of traction. I've done a lot. So about 600 books so far.
Not bad.
I mean, I've been grinding up and down the highway. I had a book release party in D.C., and I ran out of a club, but it was during the daytime, and I actually had the Howard University Marching Band come out and perform. So it was a surprise.
You believe in doing it big.
Yeah, I mean, because I spent 2 years of my life writing that book, and I'm not going to just sit on it and, you know, go by it a small way. I want to be a big impact, so I put a lot of time in it, being the party planner, and I had Howard University Marching Band come out and perform, and it was a surprise to about 200 people. Nobody knew, and they performed a different song, because it's a book about college stories, so right. I have the band come out, that's another thing, just through God, because I didn't know how I was going to get the band there, but I got them all, 60 of them there, plus the dancers, and the flag girls, and the trombones, and that's a lot moving those in the band.
So when you going to do something like that in A?
In the A?
To introduce the A to this very fine piece of literature, a lesson learned.
I want to do it soon, but it takes a lot of time and money and coordination.
Yeah.
And I want to do it soon because I think that would be real cool to have it down here. But the spiritual walk and God's guided me through this path with this book has just been amazing. So,
when you refer to the spiritual work in building the book and making it through the process, tell me what about it led you in a spiritual direction?
Because I kept going in circles in my life, and I needed to change. I just got tired of going through the same things. It's like you're going through the same things every year.
So writing the book was cathartic for you?
Yeah, very cathartic. And it just, I knew it was giving me a release, and it was my purpose and something that I had to do. And I talk to people all the time, and a lot of people don't have ideas. So I think if you get an idea, I think that's a blessing. And I think you should act on it as soon as you can, because if you don't use it, somebody else is going to get that idea.
Yeah, it's
going to
pop in somebody else's.
Because I've had a lot of ideas, and I've seen them materialize in other people's I was like, I had that same idea. And I guess God was like, well, you didn't use it, so I gave it to somebody else. Mm-hmm. So I had that idea, and I just acted on it. And I cut a lot of people off in my life, a lot of negativity. I sat in my room for about 2 years. I stopped going out, stopped drinking, stopped smoking. I stopped doing everything. I didn't my mind clear for this because it was a big deal and a big project to bring all my friends together and get them on the phone and tell their stories that are pretty deep in their life that they probably don't want nobody to know. Because I did change some of their names around. Mm-hmm. So I had to, you know, settle down and calm down with that. And it actually worked out for me very, very well.
Man, I'm glad to know that, bro. Yeah. And the story, your story is intriguing. Perhaps you might look at a memoir.
Yeah.
About your transformation.
Yeah.
All right. How can people get a hold of this book, man?
You can go to Amazon.com, and you can also go to www.JavonBrown.com. That's J as in John, E as in Edward, V as in Victor, A as in Apple, and as in Nancy, Brown.com. You can order it there. And you can watch the book trailers there, too, like a movie trailer, and see everything.
Okay, that's JavonBrown.com.
Yes, yeah, Amazon.com.
And Amazon.com.
And Kindle.
And Kendall.
Yes.
All right, then. The book is entitled A Lesson Learned. The author's name is Javon Brown. And again, let's welcome him to the movement.
Thank you so much,
man. And y'all get out there and go cop that, particularly if, matter of fact, I'm going to get this to my son.
Okay, yeah. And let him go ahead. He's a freshman going.
He's headed to Morehouse.
Oh, that'd be perfect. I'm trying to get in the freshman seminar program, so I'm going to talking to a few schools in this. Looking like it's
going to
happen.
Okay. I'm going to let him get a jump on this. I'm going to assign it. It's going to be required reading.
Yeah, exactly.
You feel me? Because this nigga ain't doing nothing else I'm telling him to do.
He'll probably enjoy it because it's entertaining too.
All right, man. Bless.
Thank you.
Bless, black man. Thank you. Slaughter. Movement will return on the other side of the break. Lines on full blaze, and I thank you for holding. I'm coming at you, Babatunde, Carnell, Ron, Taylor, Jihad. Got you all on the radar. I'll be black when I get back with more of this thing called The Movement, so you stay tuned to News and Talk 1380 WAOK. Yeah!
And girls doing likewise, honking at the honey in front of you with the light eyes.
Honoring the legacy of Atlanta, the home of...
Because I can get a yacht in there, 9-inch bed.
Yeah, I'm tired of going to the principal's office. We're not even going to give her a reason.
Oh, man.
Good morning, Atlanta. I'm Mike Moore. It's 9 o'clock. Here's what's happening.
He wouldn't let me get up. He had the gun to my head the whole time while the other one was tearing up the place.
Terrifying moments for a mother and her children. No problem.
When she told me about it while we was in training, I was like, yeah, it's perfect.
He'll stay for home later.